सो टुडे वी विल कवर सेशन रिलेटेड टू फॉर्म्स लाइक हाउ वी कैन डिजाइन फॉर्म लेआउट फॉर्म डिजाइन विच वी हैव सीन यस्टरडे बट वी विल सी दैट इन डिटेल्स लाइक एंड दिस इज माय लिस्ट मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स वी विल कवर दैट टुडे लाइक पर्सनलाइजिंग आवर फॉर्म क्रिएटिंग सेक्शंस देन personalizing list and list control which we have seen but we will repeat that again today and we will try to add some other field like radio button field all those remaining fields and that dependent choice which we tried yesterday and it didn't work right so we will try that one as so demo Gautam demos so coming to this form let's take some real time scenarios like sometimes we get requirement from client like they want to change the label a demo user demo something they want to change but just remember like when we they said to change the label only label will get changed like this is for example this is demo choice so its background name how you can see just click on left hand side And you will see show like u underscore demo underscore choice u under this is the background name of that. As yesterday I have told you like we will have a label name for separately for event table and that will have a background name. So if your client asks you to change the label, your label can be changed, but this background name will be still be same. It won't get changed. So let's try from here. Configure dictionary. I'm giving demo city and saving it. Okay. So you can see demo city is label, but column name is still u underscore demo underscore choice. Okay. So just let's rearrange that up and down so we can work on that dependent functionality. I'm moving demo state on the top and demo city on the bottom. So in demo state, we have these two, Maharashtra and Telangana, okay? And in demo city, we have only Mumbai. I will reactivate that Hyderabad city is one, which we have. Just let me see. The dependent option is still not showing here. I will check on incident. So same here, like category is first choice and subcategory is dependent on this one. So let me open and compare what's wrong. We have these choices here, but in our case, we are seeing only choice list specification and default value. But we are not seeing this dependent field and calculated field. I don't know even why that is happening. Drop down with none. Maybe I have to give this. What? Drop down with none. Okay. Still is not coming. Okay, sorry. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Here type is string. It should be choice. I don't know why it came like this. Okay. Okay, still it is not. Sorry. Top. Sorry, it is string again. String here.
Gautam,
mm-hmm.
After saving, like after updating the choice, right?
Yes.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Just click on update on the right side.
This one.
Yeah. No, it will not change.
Yeah.
Now but just still refresh and go back. On.
Okay. Let's. Yeah. Still same.
Okay, click on this. No. Just click on the lens on the top. You can see on the right. The search
which icon. This one.
In the okay. type, not the type search icon.
Type. Okay.
Yeah, click on that.
Mm-hmm.
From here, select choice.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Then click update.
Still no. Display list of choice in the advanced view. Okay, sorry. View is different, I guess. Okay. Yeah, sorry. That view was different. That was default view earlier, but it is saying that in advanced view, we will have the dependent field. Okay, sorry for that. So here is your dependent field, user dependent field. Choose your dependent from here. Demo state. I'm choosing demo state here and saving it. Okay. So what will happen is like it will get depend on this state field. Okay. And after that, we have this Hyderabad, right? So go inside that and here a dependent value. So give Telangana. I hope spelling is same. Let me duplicate this form. Telangana. Okay. Okay. Telangana spelling is okay. Okay. Closing this. Then we have where was that? Yeah, second, Mumbai. And dependent Maharashtra. Okay, so dependent thing is done. Let's go back to our form. Go to new. So I am selecting Maharashtra. Then only Mumbai is visible. Okay. When I am selecting Telangana, only Hyderabad is visible. Okay. So good with dependent choice. For that, we have to go into configure dictionary. And inside configure dictionary, just check your view. That is in advance, which I forgot. Then on that, you will have this dependent field. You have to select this one. Then select this one. From here, what will be that dependent field? Okay. Save that and open your choices on the bottom. And inside that, you will have a dependent value field. Just insert on value, what value it will be different. Like example, like in Telangana state, we have around 30 districts, right? So you can keep dependent value as Telangana for 30 times. And you can change the city names like Hyderabad, Nizamabad, all those things. So your choice will be ready. So whenever you select Telangana, all those will get pop up. Clear? And remember about this also, like we have option here, like drop down without none, drop down with none, and only none. And after selecting that, you have an option here, like choice table. You can make any table as a choice also. Like I am taking user, sys underscore user. If you want to make this table records as choice, you can even make that. So if you select that instead of adding choice manually, all the users of that table will be visible as choice. Okay. So in such way, like yesterday Rohit asked me, right, about like how we can insert like if we have state, cities, how we can insert. So create a table, add value to that, and add that choice table here. Okay. So that is about our form. And one more thing. And you can observe, like our ticket number is 1001 here and 1025 here, 1026 here. So you can say like, why are the middle numbers are getting missing? So like last number is 26, right? So I'm clicking on new again. So you can see what is the number here? It is 36. I'm going back to demos and I am clicking again new. So you can see number is 37 here. So every time you click on open, and even if you don't click, that number will get excluded. Okay. Yes. And coming to form layout. One more, just a minute. So this is our form, like here, short description, description, all these are in one line. If you want to split your form and you want to redesign your form, like we don't have HTML things here, right? So if you want, you will have these options like split end, those options. So if you want to divide, we can do that. Let me move this split to some bottom. And this end split, I am adding this somewhere here. So after description, it will get split. and work notes and all those will be on right hand side. See here. So number to description are on one side, and after that it got split, and from work notes to demo record on other side, and here split got end. And you may say like, where we'll get that split? You will get all those option on this right hand side. Let me show one thing again. Begin split. Yes, you will have this like on the left hand side. Begin split, 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 and all those things. Okay, clear with splitting?
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So then we have. This is our form. Let's load. And if you want to add a section to your form, like on the bottom, some sections. So how we can do that? So let's see here. So this is our default view. Okay, default view. And in that we have a section that is a demo Gautam. If you want to create new section, so save it. Give demo section one, some name, any name you want. Okay, so here is your first section, and so this first section has these many fields. When you click on the second section, you can see it is empty. So here I will add something. Created by fields I'm adding just for our demo purpose. So save. Okay. Here. And let me see. We have added that in our. Let me open this ticket, and we have view here. Okay, default view. This is selected. Okay, where is section then? Okay, this is our user view. This is default view, and on default view we have added created by. Okay, it is not showing. Let me add some other fields then. Okay, I will add again short description or those things. Okay, let me add this demo state. At least this should be visible. Okay, sorry. It is getting added on the bottom because we have these fields in between. So we like a demo Gautam's section start from here number, and it is still this audit history and all those things we have added on form, right? Audit record. And after that, this is your demo section. You can close and open it. Okay. So no need of any HTML or any coding. You can directly create in any n number of sections. So, and then go to your form layout. I'm choosing this section and I will use that split options. Split. So I am pulling all these three here to my form. And I will split after created by. So here it is. A created by on one side, and we have split. So demo state on another side. clear how we can create section. Okay, then again back to form layout. And yesterday we have seen that we can create view. So this is default view and this is user view. Okay, so this in user view, this demo Gautam is section. If you want to add new section here also, just click on new, give Gautam section some 1, 2, 3. And it is empty. So add some, just I'm adding a normal field just for our purpose. Okay, so this is our demo, default view, right? So I'm changing my view to user view. And here is your section, Gautam 1, 2, 3 section and close by field. Okay. And one this is about sections and views, and only admin will have the option to change his view. I have opened my form in default view and I have logged out. So next time whenever I open this form, it will show me directly in default view only. Okay, for admin. And we have created views. So you may say, like, where are we setting that rule where we can have this, like only this user for view should be visible for only end user, and only default view should be visible for admin. So for that, we have view rules. So let's take one from that. Let me pull table name if we have. Okay, table name. I'm taking example of incident for now. Okay, so we don't have incident. Okay. This is not the correct, because we are working on incident, right? So let's have a look on incident. So I have to open some record. Yes, this many we should have on incident, but why it is not showing? Okay, it is not showing here. But I will open any one of these and I will show you how we can give condition. So this is a name. You can give any some random name, and you can have some condition like if this field is match or like user. I think we have the option assigned to is any person, or let's see rules. Okay, we don't have role. Okay, so we don't have that field here, but you can arrange that condition from here. And if your condition match, so you can show, you can give your view name like Gautam demo view, or which view should be applicable. And here device type, like browser or mobile or tablet. which view you want there, and this is your table name. Let me open. I think we will have one more a view rules configuration thing somewhere. Not this one. Okay, not this one. I think here. So. Let's pull table. Okay, we don't have table name. Let's see, created by this form. Created descending. So this is our view which we have created yesterday, right? User view. Here it is. Yeah. Our view name, its title, which application it is, and form. It is on this form. And then that has two sections, that is Gautam, demo Gautam, and this one on that we have created this section, right? So that is here. And we can give any particular roles from here. Okay, let me try with ITIL role. If meeting gets end, I will send you new link, okay? So I am sending only ITIL user can, ITIL user should view that user view. So let's check. And save from here. Save or update. So I will try to impersonate as ITIL user. Okay, sorry, we have not given that access to him, right? Okay. Because we have not given access, it is not visible to that person. Dot list. So let me try with this role. Views. This Gautam role I'm adding here. Now let's check if Abil Tutor will see that default view or what. It's Abil Tutor. Demo Gautams. And I'm opening this ticket. On the bottom, okay, I think still it is default view. Okay. Still it is showing default view. I will check why it is showing, because we have to give roles there and it should show him only this particular view. Oh, sorry. I will check about that, like what is not working here. Okay. So next we will go to configure. And on the bottom of incident form, I think you have seen we have tabs, right? So how we can write add that tabs. So configure related list, and there we can add affected, like I'm adding this one, and affect, I am adding this affected group tabs. So it will get added as a tab on the bottom here. Okay, affected CI, affected group, like if we, this is your ticket, so what is the affected group? You can add that here. So clear, like how we can add a form, like dependent choice, how we can create a view, how can we create a section, how we can add related tabs on the bottom. So clear about this?
Yes,
that views one, I will check today and I will let you know tomorrow how we can give particular view to role. And then what we have, personalizing form is done. Creating new section on form is done. We will check this list and list view. Different type of fields is done. Dependent choice field is also done. So this is our list view, right? And on the, I think on second day or third day, I have explained you, like if you want to add choice of this field of your wish, you can directly pull from here and you can drop here. Okay, so that is one thing, but it will be visible only to you, only to like any end user can configure from this. Personalize is admin can do, anyone can do. But if you want to have a common list view for all the users, then you have to go. Okay, I'm admin here, right? Yes. Give me a minute. Why is that option not working? Okay. So this is our contextual menu. And from here, configure, go to your list control. And there we have seen that we can add, sorry, not this one. This is to hide or omit any button. Configure list layout. Okay. And if you want to make these fields available for all the users, like common list view, you can add that here, okay? And if that is not visible, sometimes it will not be visible. So at that time, you have to replace, like there will be option on the bottom to reset your personalized list column. And only after that, it will be visible for end user, okay? Like for example, we have added active activity due and actual end. So let's see how AbleTutor see this. So yes, he is able to see because he have he didn't modified his view, personalized view. So he is able to see common view, which a developer admin person has configured. So let's try to add something from here. So you can see this person has added this field, closed by company and configuration items. But this view, these three fields will be only visible only for AbleTutor, not for any other user. Okay. And he can reset to default columns. When he reset to default columns, the admin has set it right, that view will be visible for him. Clear? Like how we can, this is, if you want to modify from here, we call that as a personalized list modifying. And if admin set your list layout, that will be affected for all the users. Clear? Or any queries on this? One more thing. So when when we are we are working on any project, this you can have a look in this configure dictionary, because this is the important concept where we make all the changes. Okay. Okay, we have only 1 minute. I will share you new link. From that we can continue. Okay, give me a minute.